In this video, we're going to test out Rube. Rube is a super assistant that can connect to 500 different apps and perform over 50,000 actions on your behalf. And there's zero technical setup. And what makes it even cooler is it has shared memory and authentication across all of your apps. And you're going to see some really agentic tasks later in this video where you'll see the agent thinking about how to solve things in real time, which really impressed me. Thanks so much to Rube for sponsoring this video. I'm really excited to show you what this tool can do. And click the link in the description to try out Rube for yourself. So here we are inside of Rube. In the Rube dashboard, you can see which apps you've connected to. So far, I've connected to my Google Analytics and my Reddit account. But then in the marketplace, you can see there are over 500 different apps that you can connect to. By connecting to apps, you're giving the LLM the ability to get data from those apps or take action inside of those apps. Each app is going to be a little bit different. So for example, you can click into Gmail and we can see what tools it has once it's connected. So once it's connected, you would be able to create an email draft, delete a message, fetch emails. All of this is possible when the Gmail connector is set up. And each one of these connections is going to have different tools available to us. So for YouTube, get channel analytics. This is pretty cool. Maybe we'll test this out later in the video. So this is the Rube dashboard. Now you can use the Rube chat and just do everything right inside of Rube, which is actually a really great way to do it and something that I found myself doing and getting a lot of value out of. But what you also can do is add Rube to apps like Claude or ChatGPT. So to do this, I just went down to the bottom left. You can see the platforms, ChatGPT, Claude. They give you simple instructions to follow to get it installed. And then once it's installed, you can use it inside of those applications. And that's what I'm going to show you in this video. So here, just to give you an example, I've set it up. You have to go into developer mode in ChatGPT, and then you just add Rube as your connector. And then it's able to then connect with Rube and then all of the applications that you've connected Rube to. But here I said, hey, Rube, tell me my latest Google Analytics data. I just went through a couple chats to tell it which analytics account to go to. And then here we can see this is the 7-day trend for the users going to the No-Code MBA website. And here we can see sessions, active users, total users, conversions. I actually don't think this is accurate. I think that my conversions aren't set up correctly in Google Analytics, but it's cool to see that it just pulled this all in, and to have this all in one place in ChatGPT is really nice. And then even just in general, it's really nice. I know for myself, I never really want to go into Google Analytics to look up this data. So it's nice to be able to just have it here when I want to be able to see what's going on. And then there's some insights as well, which is really nice. And then just to show you what's possible, we can see ChatGPT is asking if it would like me to visualize this as a chart so we can see the trends more clearly. So I'll just go ahead and say yes. And let's see what we get here. This is really cool. ChatGPT just visualized this using my real data from my Google Analytics account. And you can do literally anything you want. You would just have to ask ChatGPT to do it. And then it's going to use the data that you have. So this is just one example, but I've got a few other really cool examples to show you. So you're going to want to stick around until the end of the video. So the next thing I'm going to do is show you how to use Reddit information inside of Rube. So this is another app that I have connected. So you just have to connect it to your Reddit account. And then you can click in to see the tools that you have available. So it can create a post, delete a comment, search posts on different subreddits. There's a lot of different things that it has access to. And then here I'm going to do this inside of Rube to show you what it looks like when you do it here inside of Rube instead of in ChatGPT. So let's say I want to look up the top posts in r/no-code. So I could say, hey, Rube, can you find the top posts in r/no-code on Reddit right now? I want the top 3 posts. And you can see Rube is going to start thinking. And then in a second, it's going to start searching the tools that it has available. And it should find the Reddit tool to search the subreddit. And then we'll get our results. And here it's retrieving the top posts from r/no-code. So it looks like there's a product launch post, a place to buy and sell automation workflows, and 1,000 free directories can use in sites to launch your startup. So if I click on that, I can see, yes, that was posted 9 hours ago and has 14 upvotes. And then I can go back to r/no-code and we can see that was one of the top posts. So that did work correctly. Now let's see if we can do something a little bit more maybe advanced. So let's say, can you search Reddit and find me three people who recently posted asking where they can learn vibe coding. So the idea here is if I can use this tool to find potential customers for No-Code MBA that I would want to reach out to and potentially share No-Code MBA with them as an option for them to learn how to vibe code. So let's see how well it does for this. So it's searching Reddit posts where people ask about this. And this is where Rube is really powerful. So we can see it is looking at the results each time and comparing it to my question. So it says the search results weren't showing relevant posts. So let's try a different search strategy, maybe where people are asking about it in different terms. So instead of just giving me results that I wouldn't be happy with because they didn't match, it's thinking about how it can search in a different way. That I think is really powerful, and it's really cool that Rube has that built in right here inside of the chat. Here we can see it's getting posts from the vibe coding subreddit, which I actually didn't even know exists. So let's see what it is able to give us. All right, we have three results. The first one is from today, and it says, I'm not a coder, but I have a basic understanding of coding. I want to start learning, isn't really sure. This is actually really cool. This could be a perfect lead. Let's see the next one, looking for inspiration. I would say that this is maybe not quite as accurate of exactly what I'm looking for. This one, engineering expanding skills, struggling with UI, UX, any AI tools to help generate good designs and UI elements. Okay, yeah, this again could be a cool person to reach out to. Maybe they're someone newer into AI coding and would be interested. So overall, I found two out of three that I think are good, and we could keep iterating on our prompts to get more. I could have had it do 10 people and just searched for longer. So overall, really impressed with what it was able to do there with getting data from Reddit and actually searching like Reddit directly. Now, the next tool we're going to test out here in Rube is Notion. So to do this, we're just going to connect our account, connected Notion to my Rube account. And then again, we can see all the tools that it has access to. A lot of it has to do with creating pages, writing on pages, getting data. This can be really helpful if you have all your company data within Notion. It's basically just a database that Rube is going to have access to. And then, of course, if you have it connected to Claude or ChatGPT, like we did earlier, you then have it in those tools as well. So let's do a new chat real quick. And let's say, hey, Rube, can you please create a new page in Notion called My Task List for October? And this is just an example to show you what's possible. And here we can see it searched the tools, it created a plan, and that it created a page inside of Notion, and it even linked to that page. So let me click on that and just see if it worked. And yes, here I am in my workspace, and I can see it created a new page here called My Task List for October. This to the next level. Let's say inside that page, can you please create a workout plan to, let's say, gain 5 pounds of muscle in October? And here we can see it just added a workout plan inside of Notion. I can view the page, and yep, it is now there inside of that task list for October that it just created. We now have a workout plan that it just created as well. So really cool to see how this is all connected together. Now let's combine these together and see how you can have different tools talk to each other. And this is where it gets really powerful. So let's go into a new chat real quick, and I'll say, hey, Rube, can you get today's user data from the No-Code MBA GA4 Google Analytics and add it to a new Notion page? So this is where we're going to get data from Google Analytics, and then we're going to add it to a Notion page. So we're connecting two different tools together. And let me know in the comments what you think of Rube, if this is something that you could see yourself using. Can you start to think of use cases where you would get value out of having all of these tools inside of your chat, either inside of this native chat on Rube's website or on Claude or ChatGPT, and having it all in one place? I feel like this is just the beginning of where these tools are going to go. And Rube, I'm sure, is only going to continue building onto this and giving it more capabilities. What's really cool about these types of tools is as the AI models get better, those are going to plug into Rube and then give it even more functionality and capabilities. So that's something that I like to think about when I'm looking at different tools. And let's see how well Rube did with this task. I'm going to go to Notion. We can see this is a new page, GA4 user data for today. Looks like we have so far 310 users, 286 new users, 419 sessions, average session duration, and a summary. Really cool that it was able to do this all within one application and having it connect. Now we're going to do one more example here. And for this, I connected Google Maps Rube actually makes this really easy to do. You just have to sign in with Google and then your Google Maps will be connected. And just to show you real quick how many different connections there are literally over 500. So what I did is I went to the other miscellaneous, that's where Google Maps is. And I think this could be really interesting for doing some research for leads, especially if you want to contact local businesses. So we're going to test that out in just a second. So the prompt I'm going to give here is, hey, Rube, can you search for 30 restaurants in Boston, Massachusetts using Google Maps and get me their website and phone number? Give me a table of the results. So here, again, Rube is first going to search for the tools that it has access to figure out which ones it should use. You can see it's even smart enough to know that the API is a maximum limit of 20 results per call. So it's going to have to do two calls to get 30 restaurants. And here we have our results. It looks like it has 30 restaurants from Boston, Massachusetts, with the phone number and the website and the address and the rating from Google Maps. So you can just think about how powerful this is and all the different data connections that we can build here. And if you wanted to, we could go into the marketplace. And let's say we were using HubSpot, for example, or Salesforce or whatever CRM you wanted. You could have Rube take those leads, put it into that CRM, and then have your sales agent start calling or reaching out to those restaurants. So there's a lot that we can do here by connecting different tools together. We tested a bunch of different use cases of Rube, both within Rube itself and connecting it to ChatGPT. You can easily connect it to ChatGPT with their instructions and also can connect to any MCP client, such as Claude Desktop, Cursor, any MCP client you could connect Rube to and give it all of these abilities that we're doing here inside of the Rube website as well. Click the link in the description to go to Rube and try this out for yourself. It's really impressive and I do highly recommend trying it and seeing what you think. Comment below if you have any questions or if there's anything you want us to cover in a future video about Rube. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this and we'll see you in the next video.